Hi everybody, my name is Hannah and this is Pepper and Pine, and I have a project to share with you. This is for our ocean main lesson block. We are going to recreate some octopus tentacles using watercolors. Now for this project, I am using my Silhouette Cameo to help me cut a circle out of stamp material. So we are going to be making our own stamp for this project, but that's okay if you don't have a Silhouette Cameo or the stamp material. You can just use a circular lid and the rest of these products. I also have an alternative product to help you out with this project. So this is called Perfect Medium, and it is a stamp pad that is going to stay really juicy and moist once you stamp your image so that you can add embossing powder to it, and then you can use your heat tool to emboss the powder, which will change the powder from its powdery consistency to a plastic consistency. And that's going to allow us to have these areas that are embossed, and I can watercolor inside them and they won't bleed out into the rest of the drawing. I am using some Zing embossing powder in white. You could use any color or you could use clear if you wanted to. So I'm going to put quite a bit on, but that's okay. I'm going to tap off all of it, and the only parts that are going to stay on are the parts that had that stamp material on it, that perfect medium. Next, we want to use our heat tool in order to emboss the embossing powder. This won't work with a regular hairdryer. You do need this specific tool in order to do this. So I'm about halfway done here, and I want to do one other thing before I continue doing the rest of those suckers on the tentacle, and that is to add a different kind of resist so that I can outline my tentacles. So I'm using this resist pen. It has the consistency of like a thick glue, and you can just put it wherever you don't want any watercolor to transfer over. So I am going to use this resist pen in order to draw out where my tentacles are going to be. And then you want to make sure that you allow this medium to dry completely, and then you can start to use it. So don't use it until it's completely dry. It dries really fast and it kind of has like a rubbery feel to it. So this product is available at craft stores, and if you don't have an embossing tool, then you can certainly use this one and freehand your circles for your suckers on your tentacle, and that would probably look more natural anyway. Now, once this dries, it has a raised look to it, kind of like puffy paint, but it rubs off when you're ready to remove it, so it doesn't damage your paper at all. And you can also use this resist medium in order to do some script lettering, and then you could watercolor over it and then remove your resist medium, and then you would have like this beautiful lettering underneath. So it's a really cool product. So now I am going to use a little bit of my Mr. Huey's white opaque paint along with different shades of pink and tan in order to make the inside of each of those suckers. It's probably not the best color, but it looks so beautiful. I think you should just stop here and it would be a really beautiful project. I was aiming for it to look more like a close-up of the back of a tentacle from an octopus, and I guess it kind of looks like that, but it's not exactly what I envisioned. So next, I am using a mixture of some Stockmar paints as well as some of my Heidi Swapp Color Shine in order to get the rest of the color that's more of like a red coral for the underside of the tentacles. Once this is all done, I kind of play around with it a little bit before I move on to doing the background color, which is going to be like an ocean color. And I did spray some water in this area just so that once the color is on the watercolor paper, it kind of moves and kind of gives it a more natural look. I also did add some Heidi Swapp Color Shine in chartreuse. I was trying to just add a little green to that blue watercolor, and I don't really care for the way that it turned out, and I did wipe off quite a bit of it. I think the blue looks a little bit better. And then, of course, I am just using my spray bottle to add a little bit more water as I'm going. Since this is really thick watercolor paper, it can take quite a bit of water, and it started to dry as I was working on my project. So there's one more look at what I was trying to go for, and then I'm going to show you how our projects ended up. Now, for my children, we did alter it just a little bit because this project took far longer than I expected. So when my children did it, for my son, all we did was stamp circular like a circular stamp in order to get the suckers on the tentacles, and we did it in a brown, and I really liked the way his turned out because it's a little bit more natural. And then for my daughter, she wanted to do hers like mine, so instead of using the same stamp, I used a smaller circular image, and basically I just used the lid of container, and that way I could still get the circular image, but it just was smaller, and I feel like it was just a little bit easier. So this was a really fun watercoloring project. Not exactly what I expected, but that's okay. The results were still really beautiful. And if you want to see some of the other projects we're doing with our ocean main lesson block, you can tap on the screen right now. And if you want to see what we're up to on a daily basis, you can find me on Instagram at pepperandpine_.